What is love or loving kindness? Wish to be happy is love. And compassion is wish to free from problem, suffering is compassion. And the joy is to see the virtues, the good qualities, the happiness within you and within others. And you feel happy about it. You feel joy. That's a joy. And then equanimity is you try to feel this joy with everyone. So the essence of generosity is the mind of letting go. Whatever we do in our life, to begin with whatever, first we let go and then give ourselves to whatever the situation. What we want to give, you can give whatever virtuous things. All your practice, meditation, your wisdom, your generosity, patience, whatever six parameters you have. And if you want to give away of certain material things, if you want to imagine, that's also okay. And also your happiness. Thank you. Now please close your eyes. Now please breathing in. Now slowly breathing out. And at the same time, send your happiness, virtue, love, compassion to all beings. Breathing in. Breathing out, send your love, compassion to all beings. Breathing in. Breathing out, send your happiness, virtues to all beings. Now breathing in all beings, problem, suffering into you. Breathing out. Breathing in, take all beings, problem into you. Breathing out. You can do by yourself. Now, both with one breath, when you're breathing in, take all beings, problem into you, suffering into you. When you breathe out, give all your virtues, happiness, love, and compassion to all beings. If you are not comfortable with one of those, you can do just one. Please open your eyes and rest your mind in open awareness. Just be. essence of ethical conduct, that sense of confidence, and also very happy. You feel like you're transparent. You feel like you can trust yourself. You can believe yourself. And then you can find sense of kind of like who you are. And the meaning of life also comes from the maintaining ethical conduct. So, if we don't have the sense of this ethical conduct, even if we are very smart, even if we are very smart, even if we are very talented, we can do a lot of things. But you can see some people look very successful, very powerful, but the personal life, they are really, really miserable. They are not happy. Why? Missing the ethical conduct. If you want to transform something, or if you want to develop something, to learn something new, you need to work with this ethical conduct. So even though you have nice idea, you have great wisdom, you have nice feeling about whatever you want to do, but if there's missing the ethical conduct, then, in the end, your bad habit will win. Please think of in your life, which one you want to improve, or transform, or help others. From which direction? One of these, which one is important for you right now? So they will have a lot of problems. So whatever we do, there's ups and downs. So the fruition is here. And when we begin, we are bottom of this mountain. So if we want to go up, there's no straight line. Thinking that there's straight line is just fantasy. It's an illusion. So the reality, you go a little bit up, then you will come down. Go up, come down. Up, come down. Each time, you get better, better, better. To really work with this up and down, we need patience. So you have to open-minded, and you have to be flexible and resilient. So this is really important. So essence of patience. And how can we have this? How we can develop this the resilient mind? From two things we can develop. One is from the wisdom from the head. One is from the heart. Loving kindness and compassion. So if you join these two together, then it really helps to open our mind, become more open, more vast. For example, from the wisdom, if you know whatever you do, there's up and down. If you know your life is up and down, then when you face a problem, you are ready. And it will not become a surprise for you. And the compassion is the try to understand your feeling and the feeling of everyone else. And you and everyone connect. And they all are same as you, even though they are making a lot of problems. But the deep level, we are same. We are like same part of family. joyful effort. So the essence of this joyful effort is the mind of inspiration, interest, and their sense of meaning. What makes to continue to keep going? Your meditation, your spiritual path, or your life, the healthy life? You have to know the reason. So why you're doing this, and for what, and what the benefit. So you have to know the reason. You need the balance. A sense of flow, a sense of rhythm. We have to let it go also time to time. We have to start. Then we need to have some balance. Then our mind don't be too attached to that. So sometimes we have to change. Sometimes we have to do something new. Let it go. How to develop the motivation, the sense of the interest? Thank you. you have to put some kind of meaning for this, whatever you're doing. For you, for example, if you meditate, the meditation is good for your mind, makes you more happy, joyful, not just happy, you become more creative. And not just happy and creative, also good for your physical body. And not only that, also good for your life. And not only good for your life, it will benefit for others. Others, life for others, your friends, your family, your colleagues, the society, the country, the world. Without virtue, then you don't see meaning, and that will not really inspire you from the heart level. Virtue, without virtue, you will not have this joyful effort. And your spiritual life becomes wonderful and can continue. And also, your healthy, normal life. Is inspiration, interest, and there's a meaning. See the meaning. So your mind is fresh and you can continue to your whatever you're doing. Thank you. the essence of meditation is awareness. A joyful experience, peaceful experience, clarity experience, non-conceptual experience, all these are not the essence of meditation. Thoughtless state of mind is not the essence of meditation. These are the experience of meditation. It's like byproduct of meditation. So what is the essence of meditation? The essence of meditation is awareness. So what is awareness? Awareness meaning to know what you are thinking, what you are feeling, what you are seeing, what you are hearing, what you are doing. So that's the awareness. So we have thought and emotion, normally we are one with that. We don't see. Once we see, they're separate. There's a sense of separation. You don't have to make separation. It comes byproduct. So that's the experience again. A sense of freedom, then there's sense of non-judgment also, because any object is okay. Positive, negative, neutral, or there's nothing there, also okay. There's nothing there, you know nothing there. If something there, you know it's something there. So that's the essence of meditation. So very easy. Thank you. So once you know, you recognize the awareness which is the essence of meditation, then you know the secret of meditation. If you recognize awareness and be with awareness, maintain that awareness, you are in meditation. Meditation is the essence of the spiritual path, if you enter the path of inner exploration, meditation is really important. Part of enlightenment, meditation is really important. What is the essence of the wisdom? Knowing the nature of reality, knowing the truth. So what is the meaning of paramita? Paramita meaning gone beyond. It's beyond concept, beyond confusion, ignorant, the dualistic state of mind. Thank you. to go deep into the nature of reality, the reality become more fuzzy, become more uncertain. It changes. So impermanent. And there's no, you cannot really pinpoint. So it is independent. And there's no single. You cannot really control. So, impermanent, no single, so many pieces, and interdependent. And if you more look into the real essence of reality, you cannot find. Nothing is there. It's empty. It's completely open. It is spacious. It is free. The real freedom is the real essence of the reality. So in that moment, what we call gone beyond the concept, that's the real meaning of Paramita. And that is what we call emptiness. But it is nothing. It's not nothing. Beyond yet, everything comes out of emptiness. Everything in the emptiness and the interdependent, impermanent, the multiple, all these different pieces is in the emptiness. Such freedom, the basis of everything. And when you really explore into yourself, into your mind, you can see that through experience. All this thought, emotions, perceptions, all this comes, but as an is, cannot be found. The pure awareness. Awareness beyond concept, yet all the concept can arises within that state. the wisdom is the most important part in the Paramitas.